was sat at the table in the back of the king, and we brought our usual bottle and a pair of glasses. Charlie poured me a drink, and normally we pour our own. So I was prepared for bad news when he said it. I'm the lead man on this one. Who says? Commodore says. He wants to pay for a lead man? That's fine. But it's bad business to short the man underneath. I got my leg gouged out and my horse burned to death working for him.
We're to find and kill a prospector in California named Herman Kermit Warren. He is solitary in nature, but often spends long hours in the San Francisco saloons, passing time reading his science and mathematics books, or making notes in their margins. He hauls these tomes around with a strap like a schoolboy, for which he is mocked.
I have seen him fight several times, and though he typically loses, I do not think any of his opponents would wish to fight him again. He is not above biting, for example. Why doesn't Morris kill him? That's always your question, and I always have my answer. It's not his job, but ours.
I was walking down the street when out the corner of my eye I saw a pretty little thing approaching me. She said, I never seen a man who looks so all alone. Could you use a little company? If you pay the right price, your evening will be nice and you can go and send me on my way. I said, you're such a sweet young thing, why you do this to yourself? She looked at me and this is what she said.
Would you not call yourselves killers?
Just because of our guns and you assume it?
I assume nothing. I know by the dead man following behind you.
I am the lead man. Yes. Well, I am. You cannot lead your horse without assistance. Also, you are sickly. You invite sickness and worry. If you were not a blood relative, I would have kept you back a long time ago. In fact, the Commodore asked me to do this, but I said no. He admired my faithfulness. Faith will be repaid with faith, he said. He has faith in me. Who do you know has faith in you?
Not even 15 minutes later, I'm still walking down the street when I saw the shadow of a man creep out of sight. And then he swept up from behind, he put a gun up to my head, he made it clear he wasn't looking for a fight. He said, give me all you got, I want your money, not your life, but if you try to make a move, I won't think twice. I told him, you can have my cash, but first you know I gotta ask, what made you want to live this kind of life? He said, there ain't no rest for the I got bills to pay, I got mouths to feed. There ain't
is it that people go crazy? It's just a thing that sometimes happens. Could you go truly crazy and then come back? Not truly crazy. No, I don't think so. Do you remember that first rifle of mine? That gun that Father called my pea shooter? He made no jokes about it when I began pulling that trigger.
Money from the church, he stuffed his bank account with righteous dollar bills. But even still, I can't say much because I know we're all the same. Oh yes, we all seek out to satisfy those thrills. You know there ain't no